Yes, can we start now? And I'm so happy that at least now, because yesterday when I came here, everyone was just in this mood. And I'm happy at least now you're utilizing the objective of the workshop. And you're sharing your concern. And I know there are two or three points for which even at present, even I don't have a solution. And those are good points. Those are two or three are very good points. Let me work on it. कोई अच्छा solution, let me find out, I'll give it to you. एक point मेरे पास आया, I'll share it अभी. Second point which came up during the discussion was about service tax. See, taxation is not my field still. I'll check that service tax point and get back. Third, the query was about if any item is less than 5,000, can we charge to income expenditure? Earlier, yes, there was a rule in Companies Act. Now, once I start the presentation, I'll pick, I will not go into theory part. I'll pick the major points which are relevant for us. So even though 5,000 ki limit bhi, ab scrap ho chuki hai. Then there was one point, sir, if we get it approved from the management, then what happens? सर आई एग्री आपके न्यू फॉर्मेट में लिखा हुआ है वो पॉइंट भी आई हैव टू डिस्कस विद बख्शी साहब बिकॉज इट नीड्स टू बी चेंज्ड और रिवाइज और अमेंडेड अभी देखते कब आएगा अभी नहीं मे बी इन फ्यूचर आई विल गिव माय सजेशन आई एग्री उसमें लिखा हुआ है न्यू फॉर्मेट में लिखा हुआ आई डोंट डिनाई दैट आई एम जस्ट शेयरिंग कि अर्लियर वो आया कहाँ से है सर उसका ओरिजिन कहाँ है दैट वॉज गिवन अर्लियर अंडर द कंपनीज एक्ट कंपनीज एक्ट में से पहले लिखा हुआ था ये कि ऑल आइटम्स विच आर लेस देन 5,000 शुड बी चार्ज टू प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट मैं उसको डिनाई थोड़ी कर रहा हूँ मैं तो अभी सजेशन दे रहा हूँ आपको मैं तो गवर्नमेंट ने अगर परफॉर्मेंस डिज़ाइन किया है वी कैन ओनली से कि भाई ये पॉइंट्स हैं तो शायद फ्यूचर में अगर आप चेंज करना चाहें आई कैन ओनली गिव मे पॉइंट्स आई नो गवर्नमेंट डिज़ाइन कर लिया बट सर गवर्नमेंट ने अगर कोई डिज़ाइन किया है क्या वो पत्थर की लकीर कभी चेंज नहीं होता कभी ना कभी सर कोई सेशन देगा तो चेंज होगा ना गवर्नमेंट ने जब वो फॉर्मेट बनाया था ना सर जब बना था वो 2013 से पहले बना है फॉर्मेट तो इन्होंने क्या किया था कंपनीज एक्ट पुराना पकड़ा उसके प्रोविजंस लिए और डाल दिया उसमें
स्टिल दैट इज वैलिड नो सर
हाँ अभी तो सर अभी तो मानना ही पड़ेगा
एंड व्हाई वी शुड चेंज वी शुड नॉट चेंज
सर चेंज की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ मैं आपको व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज कि ये पहले ओरिजिन आया कहाँ से कंपनीज एक्ट से आया अब कंपनी तक में वो चेंज हो गया सो मे बी इन फ्यूचर अगर वो आएगा आई एम जस्ट शेयरिंग द नॉलेज विद यू ठीक है मैंने ये नहीं कहा कि वो चेंज हो रहा है मैं कौन चेंज करने वाला सर चेंज करने वाले ये सब बैठे हैं सर हम नहीं है एज सर इज सेइंग कि ऑलरेडी इफ इट इज लेस देन 5,000 लाइक अ पेन ड्राइव पीपल इवन शो पेन ड्राइव ऑल्सो एज अ एसेट Because it is being used for the future. But generally what happens, when it is a small amount, pehle companies act mein mention tha, ki agar small amount hai, why to create a balance sheet heavy? With small, small items. Anything up to 5,000, remove it. In AS 26, abhi I'll share it, it is written up to 25,000. Because software mehenge hote hain. So up to 25,000 is written there, charge to P&L account. इन इंटेंजिबल सर आई एम नॉट चेंजिंग इन फॉर्मेट सॉरी ठीक है आई एम नॉट हेयर टू चेंज दी फॉर्मेट मैं कौन करने वाला सर मैं तो सिर्फ जो पॉइंट्स हैं जो नॉलेज है वो शेयर कर रहा हूँ चलिए लेट्स कमिंग टू दी आई विल नॉट गो फॉर द मीनिंग पार्ट फर्स्ट थिंग विच जनरली अराइज इज वट आर द एसेट्स बिकॉज ये कल भी पॉइंट आया था वेदर इट्स अ पार्ट ऑफ करंट एसेट डेप्रिशिएबल एसेट फिक्स एसेट टेंजेबल एसेट और नॉट Depreciable asset has only three criteria, only three, which is to be used for more than 1 year, which is to be used for production or administration, and which is not for resale. Simple, which is a very common point, everyone knows it. So anywhere if you feel, because there were a lot of queries which were asked during the break also, whether we should charge it, take the example, people were asking about e-journals. There was one query from one institution, e-journal, once they take it, they have to renew it every year. Let's suppose I have taken e-journal subscription today. Next year, to get the e-journal subscription again, I will have to pay the money. That was a query from the institution. Then the query was, should we charge that amount as an asset? Should we charge as a deferred revenue or what? I was very clear, even though it's a 1 year part, so logically not for more than 1 year, right? It will, then I asked one query, can you sell it to anyone? They said, no, you can't transfer it. I'm just sharing a bit that point which was asked yesterday. The point was, if let's suppose I have taken for 13-14, then 12-13 archive is given to me. If I pay 14-15, then 13-14 is given to me. Agreed. But for 13-14 amount, I've already paid.
There are two types of contract. One is 13-14 only readable. The other is readable and archival. So if 13-14 is both archival and readable?
Agreed. If 13-14 is both, let's say, right? If it is both, are you using it for more than 1 year? Yes, you are using it. But all assets have minimum sale value. Can you transfer it? Can you sell it to someone else? No. Any capital expenditure, first of all, we always look at this point, whether it has a saleable value or not. Take the example of a chair. Chair kitna bhi scrap ho jaye, still at least you can sell it for 10 rupees or 5 rupees. That is irreducible.
Apart from the criteria of use of saleable value or whatever, there is another point that out of grants, when we purchase assets out of grants, it is basically the whether it is the grant is for capital asset, for example.
Sir, plant, aayega bhi. Sir, wo aayega bhi.
So if we are, for example, if we are purchasing, say, journals which you are just discussing, out of allocation, the allocation is out of plan grant for books,
right,
and journals, for example,
right.
And the library is maintaining archives.
Right.
Okay. Now the subscription is on calendar year basis.
Right.
Okay. So one point is that while making payment for subscription, say for year 2014, a certain part will fall in the current year. And
so advance income ka
lagega na? Okay. Okay. That's not the point. Main point is that over the period, the journals, subscription to journals, which was normally for hard copies, now they have moved to e-journals.
Right.
Now, while making payment for subscription of e-journals, the payment is a form of license,
right,
to use. It's not that you are, sometimes the license is only for reading only, read only, or whatever, it could be conditioned. The point is the journal has been subscribed out of plan grant, which is capital grant. The grant allocation.
Sir, you come to your right specific point.
Yes.
I know what you're talking about. It's a license fee. The
point is the allocation or the grant is a capital grant or a non-recurring grant out of which the institution is making payment for subscription for 1 year, which has to be taken as recurring expenditure in the income expenditure account. So, when non-recurring grant is used for recurring expenses, the auditor have a valid objection that this is a.
एक बात मैं सबों को ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि plan non-plan जो ministry से हमें मिलता है, उसको revenue capital से कभी नहीं जोड़े नहीं तो हमेशा confusion होता रहेगा. Plan कभी भी हमेशा capital के लिए ही है, ये दिमाग से बिल्कुल हटा दीजिए. Plan से हम salary भी देते हैं. कौन सा कैपिटलाइज होता है, इसलिए प्लान नेचर ऑफ एक्सपेंडिचर देख के डिसाइड कीजिए. प्लान नॉन प्लान में कंफ्यूजन कभी ना रखा कीजिए आप लोग.
सर इफ आउट ऑफ प्लान ग्रांट अ सर्टेन एलोकेशन इज मेड फॉर
दो चीज. पहले मैं पहले दो चीज बता दूं. प्लान से रेवेन्यू कैपिटल दोनों होता है, नॉन प्लान से भी रेवेन्यू कैपिटल दोनों होता है.
ठीक है.
So, no, my कोई मिस एलोकेशन नहीं है.
नो सर, पॉइंट इज इफ एलोकेशन आउट ऑफ सर्टेन ग्रांट इज फॉर creation of asset.
Okay.
That's books, for example. And while utilizing that grant,
we come across subscription of journals, which we are archiving. I mean, archive is maintained, so we are going to capitalize it. We are making
a subscription of journal annual.
Yes.
Why you will capitalize?
We are maintaining an archive. The library maintains an archive, and it's maintained over the period. The journals are subscribed by library, which is maintaining an archive. So we are capitalizing it along with books.
Sir, वो नहीं होता है ना. I'll come to that point. ठीक है. That's what I'm saying.
वो नहीं, वो आपका matter clear है. लेकिन एक चीज हम बता दें. चार साल से मैं भी देख रहा हूँ एनुअल अकाउंट्स, तो प्लान नॉन प्लान से रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंड रेवेन्यू और कैपिटल को कभी मैच नहीं कराई है. वो हमेशा कन्फ्यूजन करेगा, क्योंकि हमें दिमाग में क्या सेट किया हुआ है बहुत लोगों को कि कैपिटल, ये जो प्लान मिला उसे कैपिटल ही क्रिएट करना है, लेकिन सैलरी भी तो हम देते हैं उसे.
माय पॉइंट इज नॉट दैट. माय पॉइंट इज
अ नॉन प्लान हमेशा रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर है. इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी.
इट इज नॉट ऑल्सो करेक्ट.
नॉन प्लान से हम कैपिटल भी क्रिएट करते हैं.
यस
सर, दैट इज नॉट माय पॉइंट. माय पॉइंट इज इफ द एलोकेशन इज फॉर क्रिएशन ऑफ एसेट.
एलोकेशन में कहां क्रिएशन ऑफ एसेट लिखा ही नहीं रहता है. प्लान में टीचर की सैलरी आती है, कौन सा एसेट क्रिएट कर रहा है.
प्लान में बुक्स भी है, इक्विपमेंट भी है.
नहीं नहीं, तो वहां कीजिए ना आप.
हाँ ठीक है, मैं कहता रहा हूं.
प्लान में नेसेसरीली कैपिटल क्रिएट होगा, नॉट नेसेसरी.
सर आप कुछ कर दें. बख्शी सर भाई.
यस, आई एम अरोड़ा फ्रॉम टिपला ITM ग्वालियर. गवर्नमेंट इंटेंशन फॉर दिस सेपरेटिंग दिस प्लान एंड नॉन प्लान इज बोथ द एक्सपेंडिचर दैट इज recurring expenditure and the capital expenditure, both we can done from plan. The government intention is plan expenditure is only meant for creation of the assets. Whatever assets we are creating, if any salary is paid for the creation of the assets, salary is paid for the this security staff for looking after the that building which is under construction, that is to be charged to the plan expenditure. This is the intention of the government, that recurring expenditure which is used to be used for the creation of the capital assets, that is to be plan expenditure.
We are here to discuss the points and discuss the points. I'll cover it. Please sir.
Planning Commission ne ek classification of expenditure already release kiya hua hai. उसमें ये बताया कि अगर प्लान पीरियड में कोई भी नई स्कीम आती है ड्यूरिंग द वन प्लानिंग पीरियड, जैसे 5 साल का प्लान पीरियड है, अगर कोई भी नई स्कीम कंसीव करती है गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, तो उससे रिलेटेड सारा एक्सपेंडिचर, चाहे वो रेवेन्यू नेचर का हो चाहे वो कैपिटल नेचर का हो, वो सारा एक्सपेंडिचर जो है वो प्लान में ही जाएगा, प्लान को ही चार्ज होगा. ये उसकी इंटेंशन है गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया की.
सर
लाइक न्यू IITs.
एक्चुअल में सर इनकी जो प्रॉब्लम आ रही है वो दूसरी है, प्लान और नॉन प्लान की नहीं है.
उन्होंने क्वेश्चन को रेज कर दिया था
सर. एक मिनट, प्लान में जो एक्सपेंडिचर्स हेड्स हैं वो अलग अलग हैं, जैसे बिल्डिंग के लिए है, बुक्स एंड जर्नल्स के लिए है, रिक्यूरिंग एक्सपेंडिचर्स है, उसके बायफ्रिकेशन में एक दिया हुआ है बुक्स एंड जर्नल. तो उसमें इनका शायद मुझे लगता है वो कहने का है कि बुक्स एंड जर्नल वहाँ कैपिटलाइजेशन नॉन रिक्यूरिंग एक्सपेंडिचर में शो करने के लिए दिया हुआ है. यदि हम बैलेंस शीट में P&L में उसको रिकरिंग एक्सपेंडिचर में ले जाएंगे तो यूटिलाइजेशन जो सर्टिफिकेट है वो मिसमैच हो जाएगा. मे बी ये था, तो इसको क्लियर कर दीजिए सर.
सर बहुत सिंपल है. अगर आपके प्लान फंड्स के अंदर, ठीक है, बुक्स एंड जर्नल के लिए आपको कोई भी ग्रांट मिला, तो लॉजिकली आपने प्लान फंड में उसे यूज़ किया, आपने उससे परचेज किया. बट प्लीज़ अंडरस्टैंड, गवर्नमेंट इंटेंशन इज दैट यू आर यूजिंग इट फॉर सम पर्पस, राइट? But plan fund and the accounting can never correlate. We have to go by the regulations, accounting standards and the concepts. It's very simple. You have taken, let's suppose I have taken a land out of plan funds, 100 rupees land and 100 rupees grant. And if I am following a net approach, which is given in AS 12 government grant, grant ko treat karne ke do method hai, income approach or capital approach. I'll be covering it. If I am following an income approach, means land 100, grant 100, I'll pass a simple entry, right? Land account debit to capital fund, 1 rupee, 1 rupee, finish, net, no depreciation, even the building, computer, anything.
I want to say the question was whether the subscription for e-journal or database subscription will be capitalized or not in the accounts.
Yes.
My, I can share my experience, what we are doing in IIM Calcutta is that we see whether the e-journal or database subscription that we are subscribing from the vendor is perpetuity or not. Perpetual or non-perpetual. Perpetual means if the subscription is closed, even if we can, you know, see the back volume, then it becomes a property of the institute and we are capitalizing it. But if it is a not perpetual kind of thing, because for example, in the next year, if I do not pay the subscription, then they will not give us the password and we cannot access the software. In that case, we charge it to the revenue. This is our approach.
I'll take 2-3 examples here. But once you have raised the point, let me take 2 or 3 points.
One more small supplementary there, and then you can clarify. So under plan and non-plan allocation, we receive both kind of components, capital as well as revenue. The point raised by him is that the allocation for the books is made under capital. Am I right? That is the confusing area. If the allocation is under capital and subscription is for 1 year only, whether that capital fund can be booked under revenue.
Sir, please understand.
I'm just telling. This is the confusion.
Agree, it was given for purpose of books. Are they ever specifying books has to be for 1 year, 2 year, nothing?
But sir, I'm telling you, capital funds cannot be utilized on revenue item.
Sir, I agree, even I know it. But let's suppose when they are giving it to you, now you don't have an issue. I'll take two, three examples here. Two, three examples. Especially in educational institutions, nowadays recorded lectures are also purchased by most of the institutions. Along with the e-book, if I'm purchasing e-lectures are also given by number of hours you can view it. If those number of hours are over by 1 year, then logically you cannot show in balance sheet. Reason, balance sheet means it has to be a perpetual use. It can be used again and again. If any e-journal, let's suppose I have taken a subscription for any e-book, right? I have taken through Kindle. Kindle mein free bhi hote hain aur purchase bhi hai. I have taken a lot of books for 1 year. So logically after 1 year, I have to pay again. Take the example of Quick Heal. It's a license, you get it. They never give you a new CD. To renew that license, you have to pay the fees again next year. So that money which you have paid doesn't become your asset. But if you have paid, let's suppose for a project, I'm taking example, we have just taken a tally. And it's a 5-year project. So tally, the money was given by the World Bank through the grant. It's a 5 years. So logically, now for 5 years, you can treat it as like a deferred income also. Because AS 12 permits that. Why you're calling it as a capital? You simple, if you want to show in the balance sheet, show it in the balance sheet. Show e-journal, e-books, library in the balance sheet. Don't use the word capitalization, because you can treat it as a deferred income, because after 4 years, 5 years, you will have to pay it again. Let's suppose archive, ma'am, you're talking about archive. You are not paying the fees again for archives. You can use it n number of times, right? That money came from the grant, certainly. It means that now it has become your property. Simple. If you follow the AS 12 approach, that is a gross approach. Gross means whatever you paid it for book, let's suppose 100 rupees, show 100 here. Simple. And it will be depreciated over the years. If you feel that depreciation should be provided, but if you feel that no, it has a perpetual life, like a land. So no, don't provide depreciation debt. But if you feel no, archive is available only for 3 years. It's like a miscellaneous expenditure. Amortize it for 3 years. Simple logic. So I agree the planned fund is to be used for capital. I agree with it. But if you have purchased it for a book, what is capital revenue? Capital revenue is very simple. Revenue is that money which has to be incurred again and again. Every month, let's say. That's the revenue expenditure.
Plan
to have revenue component. I agree, sir. Both can both have. But if plan mein sir books likha hua hai aur apne books purchase kiya aur wo book ki subscription aapko agle saal dobare pay karni hai, तो सर आप फिर भी अगर उस बुक को जिसका यूजेबल नेक्स्ट ईयर नहीं होगा अगर आप बैलेंस शीट में दिखा रहे हैं सिर्फ इसीलिए बिकॉज उसका पैसा प्लान फंड से आया है, इट्स अ रॉन्ग ट्रीटमेंट. यू टेक आस्क एनी ऑडिटर ऑफ सी ए जी दे विल इमीडिएटली रेज अ पॉइंट.
From plan grants, e-books, procurement of e-books for 5 years or 6 years. Now most of the universities are procuring e-books.
Agreed, I agree. I'll take a very simple part, right? When we get the grant, right? We get 100 rupees grant, let's say plan fund. Agreed? That's a simple approach of AS12, which even Anand will take it, but you have raised the point, I'll be taking it here. Bank and plan funds. Now, this bank goes, for that you have purchased the e-books. That's like a balance sheet I'm talking about. Okay, simple. Fund will appear at 100. Fund will continue to appear at 100. But what is the logic of fund? Now, in your 1 year balance sheet, 2 year balance sheet, 3 year balance sheet, after 5 year also, if you show in this way, instead of plan fund, you talk about capital fund basically.
Okay.
Right?
Fine.
This is a gross approach. Gross means you are not charging the depreciation. Now, let's suppose in this year you say, no, I want to charge 20 rupees depreciation. So depreciation has to be charged to income expenditure. Over the period of 5 years, it goes. But as ma'am is saying, it's archive part, so you can use it perpetually. Am I right? Perpetually means it can be used again and again. If it can be used and again, logically, it is your asset. It should appear. But the problem is, why you want to show it in 100? The purpose is what? To show the value or to show the asset? Show the asset. As even yesterday Mr. Shyam mentioned, the logic is not to show the value here. The logic is to show the asset. So that at least if someone comes, you can say, we have 10 archives. That you can say. But over the period of 5 years, 6 years, any money goes obsolete, depreciated. So you want to show it after 5 years, 6 years. The best approach is always the net approach. First, you receive the grant. You pass the entry bank to grant. 100, let's say. It will show in your balance sheet like this. Then you purchase the book. You write the entry e-book to bank. E-book. Agreed? Now, if you want to charge a depreciation on it, you take it 5%, 10%, whatever rate you want to take.
Should we charge depreciation on it?
Why? Depreciation is what? Jiska value kam hoga. See, archives ka value aap kaise kam kar rahe ho? The content of same hi rahega na sir?
Same rahega.
It is not depreciation, I've just mentioned, just see the definition of. Please don't see ki we are doing this practice. This is the definition of depreciation. Let's see. Measure of wearing out. It's not wearing out. Please, you have to, being an accountant, you have to apply the words also sometimes. Consumption. Consumption means which you have consumed, it cannot be used again. Or other loss of value. Archives means which has a indefinite life. It means if I have taken one subscription which can be used n number of times, it can be used. My videos are available on CA Club India. If any student purchases it, they can only purchase for 2 years. So guaranteed 2 years is a deferred income. But if I give the right, use exclusively entire life. So logically life kya hoga? Infinite ho jayega. Aap kyun charge karenge depreciation? So books mein jo depreciation income tax mein likha hua hai, wo kyun likha hua hai? Reason, there are many books which are revived, changed in all the libraries. Income tax book is changed every year. I take example, I am Pandey book of financial management. Vikas Publishing House, you always go for a revised edition, new edition. You have an old edition also available there. But tell me, if a new edition is available, does a student take the old edition?
Then so, what will be the use of this old edition?
Yes, if it is not useful, then logically that book should be removed. But journals are useful. Even the old articles are referred in PhD and research. Journals are have a life, but not the books. If that book, e-book, let's suppose you have taken an e-book of I Am Pandey, right? And next year a new edition comes. Will you take the new edition or not? Will you take the new edition? No. Old edition automatically goes waste. And what's the logic of showing it at 100 rupees? Immediately remove it. So that's the best approach I'm telling you. In grants, the best approach is never to show the gross.
Okay, go ahead.
I hope Anand takes that point. Because if you take the net approach, it's the best way. Your tension of depreciation will be removed. And in my presentation, it will be covered now. Now tell me this. I've taken a very simple example here. Let's suppose, and this guaranteed you guys must be facing it. If let's suppose Sachin has purchased a Ferrari, I've taken a very simple figures. Sachin has purchased a Ferrari for rupees 100 on 1st January 14. It came to Bombay port and for custom duty he paid 50 rupees on 15 January. Now, it was transferred to his house on 31st January and he paid transportation charges 20 rupees. Then at his house, he installed some accessories of 100 rupees on 15th February. Car was ready for use on 1st March. But he used it for the first time. Isme aapko bahut sare doubts clear ho jayenge. He used it for the first time on 31st May. I am again repeating, he purchased on which date? 1st January. Amount? 100. Then it was, custom duty was paid? 15 January. Then it was transferred to his house? 1st March. It was ready to use on which date? 1st March. He used it first time on 31st May. In some of the annual report I was looking at it, in the accounting policies it is written, depreciation has been charged for the full year, whether addition is made at any time. It is written in the policies somewhere. I agreed. I am not commenting, I am just sharing the points. Please, we are here to discuss so that at least our confusion ever remove ho jaye. Now, my query is, which shayad sabke mind mein aati hai, depreciation on which cost? One is 270. Full value. Full value. Sir, up to 1st March. Very good. It means this is a cost concept basically. Total expenditure, very good, brilliant. My next query, depreciation should be charged from which date? 31st May, very good, sir. I am not saying yes, no, please. Okay? 1st March, 31st May. How many of you are saying 31st May? 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfectly fine, ma'am, I agree. Very good, 6, 7, 31st May, very good. And how many of you think 1st March? Ma'am, it should be from 1st March. I'll tell you, wait for 5 minutes. Wait for 5 minutes. You purchase your AC at your home during the winters because it was economical. Sales, sasta mil gaya aapko. You use it for the first time in the summers. Depreciation will be charged. Because depreciation is about loss of the value. It's always charged from the date when the asset is ready to use. Income tax may allow, please never mix income tax with accounts. The basic mistake, maximum of us do it, we mix income tax with accounts. Income tax profit is never same as accounts profit. Cannot be. Because of the rebate, deductions, exemption, can never be same. Take one more example. If I have taken a house on rent and my agreement is from 1st May and I have requested my landlord that I'll come back after 20 days, will he charge the rent from 1st May or 20th May? Agreement date, ready to use. On a lighter side, because now atmosphere has become very hot, let me take on a lighter side, a very good joke in this. जी बी शर्मा जी मान लीजिए सीए हैं और ये अपनी वाइफ के साथ घूमने गए, आफ्टर 3 डेज 4 डेज के बाद जब होटल से चेकआउट था तो एक बहुत बड़ा सा बिल आया, देयर वाज अ ह्यूज बिल व्हिच वाज गिवन टू हिम आफ्टर 3 एंड 4 डेज एंड द बिल वाज ऑफ 2 लाख रुपीज। ही वाज सरप्राइज्ड, इन 4 डेज अ बिल ऑफ 2 लाख रुपीज, व्हाट वी हैव डन इन 4 डेज। ही आज ही मैनेजर केम, मैनेजर शोड द डिटेल्स ऑफ द बिल। इन द बिल इट वॉज रिटन 80,000 रुपीज ओनली फॉर AC, एयर कंडीशन। ही सेड वी हैव कम टू लद्दाख, वी डोंट नीड AC। मैनेजर सेड सर सी स्विच इट ऑन, AC इज रेडी टू यूज, आपने यूज नहीं किया, पुट टू यूज नहीं है, बट इट वॉज रेडी टू यूज, आई विल चार्ज। जी बी शर्मा जी ने कहा डोंट वरी, यू आर डिस्कसिंग विद द CA। ही इमीजिएटली टुक आउट हिज लेटर हेड एंड सेड, मिस्टर मैनेजर यू आर सपोज टू पे मी 20 लाख बिल। मैनेजर गॉट स्टंड, 20 लाख, व्हाई यू हैव स्टेड फॉर 4 डेज, व्हाई आई शुड पे 20 लाख। मिस्टर जी पी शर्मा सेड यू हैव ईव टीज माई वाइफ। मैनेजर गॉट स्टंड, सर मैंने तो छेड़ा ही नहीं है। जीपी शर्मा जी ने कहा आस्क हर, शी इज रेडी टू यूज, सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर इट्स चार्ज फ्रॉम रेडी टू यूज, नेवर पुट टू यूज मैम। आई हैव टेकन एटलीस्ट 4 or 5 एग्जाम्पल्स, मेक श्योर इवन इफ यू डोंट यूज इट, देर वॉज अ क्वेरी फ्रॉम वन ऑफ द इंस्टीट्यूशन डेट वी हैव नॉट यूज द एसेट फॉर 2 years, यू डोंट यूज इट, इट्स मार्केट वैल्यू विल गो डाउन, देयर इज अ लॉस। And depreciation never only means usage loss, even if a loss due to time. Take the example of iPhone. If anyone has purchased iPhone, now the value is almost like half. Even if you don't use it. I still remember when I purchased BlackBerry, I purchased for 25,000. After 1 month, when I went for exchange, they said 7,000 rupees. I use it only for 1 month. So usage से कभी भी depreciation को link मत करिए, that's a wrong concept. Sir,
we get the construction through CPWD. See the time that the CPWD takes to settle the bills, it's very long time, more than a year or two. Though the building is ready to use or put to use, but they don't hand over the building. So normally the ready to use is when the document is transferred, when the building is actually transferred to the university. But by then the building is already put to use. So now depreciation starts at what time?
Sir, simple, ready to use means when you can shift there.
Yes.
And until, unless all clearances you get it, until you get the clearance certificate, completion certificate, you should not charge it.
But practically the building is put to use before it is transferred.
Sir, agreed. It's put to use. But it's very simple. Legal formalities are here.
Nahi hota, sir. That's what. It takes more than a couple of years to transfer it.
Koi baat. Sir, agar query hai. But CPWD ko aapne kya clearance manga hoga na aapse?
Yes.
Clearance for the building?
Yes.
Just tell me, without clearance, if you're using it, it is basically usage before the construction of the asset.
Fine.
It means if you are using it before the transfer, then logically it should not be charged from this date, from that date. At example, if you take a car and that car is transferred to your name after 1 month, then you are not the owner, you become the owner only after 1 month, no?
Yes.
Mere sahab se, it should be charged after 1 month. But how
because,
you do it?
Because as statutory audit is putting objection on this. They say that though the building is not transferred, but since you have already put to use, it should be depreciable from the date when you have put to use.
नहीं, जब तक completion certificate नहीं आएगा वो work in progress में रहेगा, और completion certificate आ जाएगा तो वो transfer होगा जो है. एक चीज, दूसरी चीज, एक और इसके साथ logic और भी, वो भी समझ लें कि उसके ऊपर कोई भी आप maintenance repairing नहीं कर सकते हैं. Even वो complete हो गया होगा तो कंप्लीशन सर्टिफिकेट जब तक नहीं आएगा तब तक उसके ऊपर कोई रिपेयरिंग एंड उसका भी खर्चा नहीं.
इट इज CWIP, इट इज कैपिटल वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस. सर,
लाइक आवर स्टेट एंड वर्क हैज सेड दैट देयर आर 200 कास्टेड बीम्स
poles, 200 casted poles, that has to be disposed of because now there is no value. Means they have shown the book value as zero. How we asked that how this book value of the 200 poles be zero. They said that because we have designed, we have for some experimental work, we have designed, and now we have to dispose of. So it, how the depreciated value calculated for these things?
So this is revaluation. You have to immediately go for the revaluation, right? Now the point is, it's exactly the same point which in Uttarakhand they have done it. If you have taken, let's suppose, an asset of 100 rupees, now if it has to be scrapped, demolished immediately, then a depreciation concept doesn't apply even. Immediately you have to revalue the asset. If they are saying revaluation has been done at 2 rupees, and 98 is a loss, immediately that loss is charged to profit and loss account. AS6 talks about it. I'll come into it. That's the revaluation. That generally happens. Take one more example. In 2008 and 9, Kasab came here, right? Taj Hotel building was almost destroyed. So for that period, they cannot charge a normal depreciation. They immediately check the balance sheet of Taj. They have, in that year, they have revalued the building to the actual value. Because in that year, they have incurred a huge expenditure to again manage, to again create a new building. So in that year, it was revalued. That revaluation loss was charged to profit and loss account. And AS6 permits revaluation. Permits a revaluation. So whenever it's an exceptional case, it's never the depreciation. You immediately revalue your asset. Or bhi aayega, isme bhi aayega. Please, sir.
Is the computer near about 50 lakhs and the delivery will happen in 30th April, 30th March.
Don't install
आप ही से रिलेटेड लेट मी टेक वन एग्जाम्पल द प्रोजेक्ट विच आई एम डूइंग इट इन दैट इन वर्ल्ड बैंक हैज गिवन कंप्यूटर्स टू 34 सिटीज बट विद अ कंडीशन द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट द सप्लायर विल इंस्टॉल इन ऑल द 34 सिटीज ही हैज इंस्टॉल्ड एवरीवेयर बट ही विल राइट get the money only when he get the certificate of completion from the ULBs. You have charge it, pay, make the payment. Asset is, you can start using the asset.
Not installed.
Sir, if it's installed, then how will it be reduced? Take the example of split AC. Split AC, I have got from my home. Right, I have made the payment, split AC is lying in a box, because the mechanic will come, he will put a pipe, he will put a fan, only then it will be ready to use. Na? Payment is a question, yoga, sir. Take the example of LED, you have taken an LED for your home, 1 week there was a strike and the mechanic did not come, you can't use it. Ready to use does not mean a box, it means you should be able to start it.
Sir, that completion point, we also, we Central University of Tamil Nadu also facing a similar problem. We have been using hostels constructed by CPWD and we are getting hostel fees for the last 2 years. And no details like my other colleague told, no details we have received. And without the value, we are not ready to capitalize. So we are showing it as work in progress, and it was become an audit sub query that CAG audit. They have written that it is not correct. So if completion certificate doesn't, we don't have confidence of getting completion certificate for the at least next 2 years. So still that till that point of time, I think we will be able to show it as work in progress. In that case, it's not reflecting the substance or form. Actually, the real thing is it is a completed building. But based on money measurement, we don't know the value. Exactly what is electrical portion or building portion, we don't know. How to go about this? And similarly, one more thing is, one some DG sets kind of it, they have supplied. And we are using it for the last 4 years. No invoice, nothing has been given. So since we have made advance payment as deposit, so we are showing it as deposit. Whereas assets are lying in our premises and we are using it for long. So completion certificate, if you are not able to get it, what will happen? I think that is a documentation process.
I agree.
Going by substance over form, what is to be done?
Sir, agreed. as it's a documentation point and still a statutory auditor is raising the point. If I go by the accounting principles, logically, till you do not get the clearance, it should not be capitalized or transferred to asset. But if still the audit objection is arising, my advice will be as a CA, take the approval from your board of governors as an exceptional case, right? Ki as the documentation is being getting delayed, and show the communication that you have at least followed up many times. Get the approval. Due to that, we are capitalizing it. But accounting principle-wise, unless clearance comes, you cannot.
And that corresponding revenue is there, hostel fee we are getting, but it is not capitalized. Without capitalizing the building, we are getting the hostel
fees. It's not necessary.
That is what written by AG.
I agree, but it's not necessary that you get the revenue only from the constructed asset. Even the under construction asset gives you the revenue. I can give them rent. Yeah. Even the partially rent. In AS10, it's clearly written. I'll take an example. I am creating a building. It is under construction, right? Yeah. Someone comes to me, please give me that building for rent for 1 month. I say, what you will do? He says, I just need to, as a storehouse. And I said, it's not ready. He said, don't worry, I'll pay you money 2 lakh rupees.
That is what the reply we are given to tackle the AG audit.
Right? So, it's clearly given in AS10. Any internally generated revenue before acquisition is subtracted from the cost.
But can we do the best judgment, some estimation of the value based on that, can we capitalize?
Sir, CAG auditor will never rely on the estimation. If till date you have incurred 10 lakh and you're getting a revenue of 2 lakh, they will clearly say subtract from your cost. Subtract the revenue from your cost. It means at present if you have not got the clearance, till now if you have incurred 101 crore rupees and after 2 years you get the clearance, then in 2 years if you get a revenue of 10 lakh, then your cost will not be 1 crore.
That BG set also is not reflected in our fixed assets.
Sorry?
That DG and other assets what we are using, for the last 4 years, it is not shown in the fixed assets. We are showing it as deposit to CPWD.
That's what I'm saying, sir. As per the accounting rules, it cannot be. And I'm telling you, show them AS10. I'll give you the paragraph. The problem is, as an auditor, when we are not able to justify it, as an accountant, I take an example. I was getting the audit done in this ministry itself. The C&AG auditor came, and they were arguing on the 194J. They were saying, no, this should be a TDS rate. I said, no, that's a rate. Just see the act. Oh, they said, oh, yes, even we are not updated about the service and the income tax rates. Then they change the paragraph. So if you have the justification, you show to them, yes, this is justification. Still, if they make the paragraph, I can't help out. But I can only say the right approach. Right approach is this, that until unless the clearance comes, you cannot capitalize it. Or sir, dekh lijiye, ye bhi wahi kar rahe. But I agree, I respect your point. Because of the audit query, you're raising it. I'll take one more example. Most of you must have read in the newspaper in Noida, Supertech, the two buildings of Supertech, which construction has been held by the Allahabad High Court. Now, until clearance comes, if the entire building is there, let's suppose they have even given the possession also, but until clearance comes, ownership cannot be transferred. Ownership cannot be transferred. Can never be transferred. As per accounting rule, it is very, very clear. It is even given in AS10. Usse pehle ka jo revenue hai, that is internally generated revenue.
Effectively, possession got transferred.
Sir, how you can say effectively it is transferred? How?
Because it is put to use by the client, that is our university.
Sir.
It is not, they are not holding that. Only documentation detail they are not.
I'll take an example. Let's suppose, sir, you sell your house to me. You sell your house to me, right? We are friends. You say to me, please go and shift to my house. But the registration process takes 3 months. So I will be owner not from today. I'll be owner only from the third, after 3 months. In Delhi, DDA allots the flat. They have just given the flat and they've given the condition. Before 10 years, you cannot dispose it off. If let's suppose my friend has given that flat to me and said, you leave it for 10 years. I will not be the owner. For 10 years. Owner only when it given the paper. And auditor always goes by the papers. Sir.
Sir, for last session, आप लोगों ने बताया था कि हम लोग we are following accrual system. और 1st मार्च को जैसे हम लोग assets का delivery हो गया, bill वगैरह आ गया. As per accrual, हम लोगों ने assets को book कर लिया और debtors को create कर लिया.
Sir, accrual accounting is applicable only for the revenue transactions.
पर सर, इस पे fix assets पे अगर हम लोग जैसे जो deficit लगाते हैं.
No. Accrual accounting is only, accrual का मतलब होता है revenue is earned and cost is incurred.
तो ऑन फिक्स एसेट पे हम लोग क्या करें सर, उसको जब पेमेंट करें तब उसको बुक करें?
पेमेंट नहीं सर, व्हेन ऑल द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन इज कंप्लीटेड.
जैसे डॉक्यूमेंटेशन कंप्लीट हो गया, व्हेन डेप्रिसिएशन चार्जेस, तो इसे स्लॉट्स है 1st अप्रैल टू 30 सितंबर एंड 1st अक्टूबर 31 मार्च. तो सर व्हाई वी आर मतलब कंसर्निंग ऑन द डेट इशू, वहां पर एक स्लॉट दिया हुआ, स्लॉट्स के अंदर फुल और हाफ डेप्रिसिएशन चार्ज किया जाता है.
सर जो आप 6 मंथ्स की बात कर रहे हैं ना, इट इज ओनली गिवन इनकम टैक्स. इनकम टैक्स एक्ट सेज You, if you have purchased the asset on or after 1st October, charge 50% depreciation. If it is purchased on 1st April, charge full year depreciation.
So generally we are following sir that system sir, in last 2-3 years.
Yahi to problem hai sir. We follow the income tax approach. Ma'am ne rightly bola, income tax is only relevant. We are relying on income tax approach. But depreciation is a time-based concept sir. Depreciation month-wise nikalta hai, day-wise nikalta hai. अगर डेप्रिसिएशन आपने अगर मशीनरी परचेज करी 15th अप्रैल को, सो लॉजिकली फॉर द इंटायर ईयर यू विल चार्ज इट. जस्ट करेक्ट मी कि डेप्रिसिएशन टाइम बेस्ड होता है नहीं होता है? बट आई एग्री इन सम अकाउंटिंग पॉलिसीज इट इज रिटर्न इफ इट इज परचेज ऑन आफ्टर 1st अक्टूबर हाफ ईयर. ये कंडीशन सर इनकम टैक्स के सेक्शन नंबर 32 में लिखा हुआ है.
और सर हम लोग इनकम टैक्स की रेट तो फॉलो कर रहे हैं जनरली, मतलब अभी मेरे ख्याल मेनली स्टूडेंट्स फॉलोइंग इनकम टैक्स रेट्स फॉर डेप्रिसिएशन.
सर प्लीज डोंट गेट अदरवाइज, वी टेक वन एज अ बेस एंड वी ट्राई टू फॉलो एवरीथिंग ऑफ दैट. इनकम टैक्स एक्ट सिर्फ एक आपको रेट आपने लिए, दैट डज नॉट मीन यू विल फॉलो एवरीथिंग ऑफ दैट, बिकॉज अदरवाइज इन दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पुट टू यूज. क्या इनकम टैक्स का प्रॉफिट और अकाउंट्स का प्रॉफिट कभी सेम आएगा सर?
सर तो वी आर नॉट प्रॉफिटेबल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, तो व्हाई डेप्रिसिएशन इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट टू अस ओनली फॉर फेयर वैल्यू शो इन द बैलेंस शीट.
एग्रीड.
तो व्हाई वी आर कंसर्निंग ऑन द रेट डेट्स एंड अदर, मतलब
सर नो फेयर वैल्यू, इफ यू आर टॉकिंग फेयर वैल्यू एंड इफ लेट्स सपोज 100 रुपीज इज द डेप्रिसिएशन कॉस्ट एंड यू हैव परचेज ऑन 1st अप्रैल, यू शुड चार्ज फॉर इंटायर ईयर. इफ स्टिल यू आर चार्जिंग इट फॉर हाफ ईयर, if you purchase on 1st July, you should charge for 9 months. If you are still charging it for entire year, it's wrong. You are showing a higher profit. आप सिंपल एग्जाम्पल लीजिए, आपका 100 रुपये का एसेट है, आपने परचेज किया 1st अप्रैल को, राइट? यू हैव चार्ज 100% एप्रिसिएशन. आई हैव परचेज ऑन 1st July, इवन आई एम चार्जिंग 100% एप्रिसिएशन, देन लॉजिकली आई शुड हैव चार्ज फॉर 9 मंथ्स. You should have charged for 1 year. If I have purchased even on 30th September, still I am charging for 1 year. Is it right? And you are purchasing on 1st April. Tell me about house rent. You purchased on 1st April. I have taken house on 1st September. Will the rent will be same? It can't be.
बट सर लास्ट प्रीवियसली वी हैव मेड द बैलेंस शीट बिफोर, मतलब 3-4 साल पहले सीएजी कम्स और उन्होंने उसको दो बाइफरकेशन करा दिया कि आप 1st अप्रैल टू 30 सितंबर एंड 1st अक्टूबर टू 31 मार्च.
सर आई अब प्रॉब्लम पता है कि डोंट वी टेक ओके दिस वी हैव बीन डूइंग इट, दिस आई अग्रीड यू हैव बीन डूइंग इट, आई एम नॉट सेइंग यू आर नॉट डूइंग इट. द पर्पज ऑफ वर्कशॉप इज नॉट कि व्हाट यू आर डूइंग, पर्पज ऑफ वर्कशॉप इज कि एटलीस्ट what are the corrective measures we can take it. I know we have been doing it. We have been doing it for 20 years, 30 years. Even we have been doing it for last 100 years. There was one institution was for more than 105 years. Bangalore mein, I think who came, yaad nahi aa raha now. Right sir, piche. 105 years. If they have been following some practice before independence, that doesn't mean you won't change it right now. The law, if today law gets changed, let's suppose your income tax rates gets changed, do you say this? I was paying income tax rate at this rate, why a new rate? We never say that. So, is the reason, sir, जो राइट अप्रोच है, आपने कहा कि फेयर वैल्यू क्यों नहीं है फेयर वैल्यू सर? अगर आप फर्स्ट अप्रैल को ले रहे हैं या फर्स्ट सितंबर को लेंगे, फेयर वैल्यू चेंज हो जाएगी सर, गारंटी डिफरेंट आएगा। आई होप आई एम क्लियर
सर। एक्चुअली ऑल द न्यूली स्टार्टेड सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी एंड अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस आर गेटिंग अ प्लान ग्रांट। इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री मेन पोर्शंस, वन इज कैपिटल, other one is salary and other one is recurring but non salary but recurring. So entire fixed assets generated by way of construction of buildings or acquired lab equipment and other things are purchased out of the grant given to us. Will it make any difference? Because according to grant, fixed assets purchased out of grant to be shown as 1 rupee value something.
Sir, 1 minute. Let me just take that.